Hi, I'm Dr. Rhonda Lowe, and welcome to Your Medical Pipeline. In this segment, we're going to talk about keeping your bones fracture-free. Many consider osteoporosis a problem only for seniors, but the disease actually starts in early life. Osteoporosis occurs when ongoing bone loss causes your bones to become more and more brittle. And it can go on for years without any symptoms until you suddenly suffer a spontaneous fracture in your spine, causing you to lose height and be hunched over, or if you fall, breaking bones elsewhere in your body. In seniors, falling and breaking bones are a leading cause of death, and there's no getting away from it. Just getting older puts us at risk. After about age 35, we gradually lose bones, so that after about age 50, 1 in 4 women will have osteoporosis. Women are more at risk than men, especially in the years leading up to and after menopause. Those with a strong family history of osteoporosis, smokers, certain ethnic populations such as Asians or Northern Europeans, and those who drink a lot of alcohol or more than 4 cups of coffee, tea, or cola a day are more at risk. Studies show that teenage girls who consume soft drinks are 3 times more at risk for osteoporosis and bone fractures compared to those who don't drink carbonated beverages at all. Fortunately, we can help prevent osteoporosis if we build bone mass when we're young. Now, there's no question that getting physical activity and enough calcium and vitamin D play important roles in keeping our bones strong. Exercise does a body good. It can reduce the risk of fractures and falls due to brittle bones. Now, while all types of exercise helps, weight-bearing activities such as walking, dancing, stair climbing, or jogging can help maintain our bone mass. Research shows that weight training is safe and perhaps the most effective. Other types of exercise help improve posture, balance, and coordination, so things like Tai Chi, yoga, and Pilates. And don't forget to stretch to help prevent strains and stiffness. If you already have osteoporosis, it's a good idea to check with your healthcare professional before starting any exercise program. And when it comes to calcium and vitamin D, it's actually more difficult than you would think to get enough in your diet. You need to be consciously aware of the amount that you're taking in. According to the guidelines, adults up to age 50 need 1,000 milligrams of calcium and 400 international units of vitamin D a day. Postmenopausal women and anyone age 50 and over need 1,500 milligrams of calcium and 800 international units of vitamin D daily. Calcium-containing foods include dairy products, calcium-fortified juices, green leafy vegetables such as broccoli, kale, and bok choy, canned salmon, and sardines with bones. Vitamin D foods include fortified milk, egg yolks, salmon, sardines, and halibut and cod liver oils. Now, exposure to sunlight helps our bones make vitamin D, but you know, if you live in the Northern Hemisphere, it can be difficult to make enough vitamin D naturally. So, for both calcium and vitamin D, you may also want to consider taking supplements to top up. All of our bone building activity goes on when we're younger, so it pays to get started early with exercise and eating right. Still, it's not too late to think prevention if you're older. So talk over your personal risks for osteoporosis with your healthcare professional to see what else you can do to help keep your bones strong. My comments are for information only and should not be used to replace a visit or the advice of your physician or other healthcare providers.